Hi, I'm Michał, a veterinary doctor specializing in animal reproduction. Today I'd like to show you why I use Doppler ultrasound in my daily work and how it can make reproductive exams in cattle herds easier. One important thing is that the Doppler function should be easily accessible, ideally activated with a single button so you can immediately see what's happening. There's a myth that the cow has to remain completely still during a Doppler exam. Of course, she shouldn't be dancing around, but even if she moves slightly, as long as your hand is steady and well positioned, you can still assess blood flow, for example, in the corpus luteum. Let me explain how I typically use Doppler. Most often, I use it to evaluate whether the corpus luteum is functional. In other words, whether there's blood flow present or not. If there is blood flow, then with high probability, we can say the corpus luteum is hormonally active and producing hormones. That means administering prostaglandin will likely cause luteolysis and bring the cow into heat. When examining the ovaries, I often check whether luteal tissue around a cyst is vascularized. For instance, if we're dealing with a luteal cyst with a wall thicker than 3 millimeters, I look for blood flow in that tissue. If blood flow is present, we can reasonably assume the tissue is hormonally active. That allows us to shorten the treatment time by administering prostaglandin, hoping it will respond. In pregnancy cases, it's crucial to evaluate the fetal heartbeat. If the heartbeat looks weak or slow, it's helpful to use Doppler to visualize the heart and assess blood flow. This way, we can judge with good accuracy whether the embryo is alive or whether it's likely to be resorbed. When dealing with late-term pregnancies in the 7th or 8th month, the ultrasound beam often can't reach deep enough into the uterus. In those cases, I assess the pregnancy by looking at the cotyledons. Using Doppler, we can check for blood flow in the cotyledons. If flow is present, then we can say with high confidence that the pregnancy is progressing normally and the fetus is alive. People often ask if Doppler is revolutionizing veterinary reproductive exams. It's not about a revolution, it's about having a tool that helps us examine animals more precisely. Of course, you can do reproductive exams without Doppler and do them effectively, but if we have a tool that improves accuracy and helps us work better, why not use it? One thing to remember when you activate the Doppler function using the D button, a box appears on the screen. You can adjust the size of that box to focus on the area of interest. Also, when using Doppler on the corpus luteum, you can record a video or take a snapshot. Just click Save Sign and you'll have a recording showing Doppler blood flow. Why is this important? Mainly for training and consultation purposes. You often send me such videos and ask, "Do you think there is blood flow in this corpus luteum or not?" And it's not like all blood flow in every corpus luteum looks the same. Even in functional corpora lutea, some have a bit less flow, others have a bit more. But after seeing hundreds or thousands of these images, you'll learn to evaluate them effectively. What's been great for me is that since I started using Doppler, I've reduced the amount of hormones I use. Why? Because when I see a clearly functional corpus luteum and a follicle of the right size on the ovary, I don't put the cow into a full hormonal synchronization program. Instead, I use a shortened protocol, which means less hormone use and a quicker time to conception. Now, I'd like to show you a few examples of when I most often use Doppler. The first case is identifying a heartbeat, especially when the examination is technically difficult and makes it hard to get a precise view of the heart. For instance, if the rectum is tense and we can't bring the probe close enough, we might only get a rough view of the embryo, but not the heart. Then we turn on the Doppler. And just like here, we can see the calf is alive because the blood flow is normal. That's one example. Of course, if we can get a clear image of the heart during pregnancy, we can also see whether it's beating properly. So Doppler is also useful when we clearly see the heartbeat, just to confirm that the blood flow looks as it should. The flows are okay. The next case is a typical gynecological examination of the uterus before insemination. We can see the uterus on the screen. The Doppler was turned on a bit earlier here because I wanted to record the full video showing what the uterus and the ovary look like. And what do we see on the ovary? We see very nice Doppler blood flow in the luteal tissue, which suggests that this luteal tissue should respond to prostaglandin. There is also a follicle with a diameter of up to 12 millimeters, so we can safely shorten the hormonal protocol, administer hormones, and prepare the animal for insemination. In the third case, I wanted to show you an ultrasound of a late stage pregnancy. Here, it's the seventh month, so the calf is positioned very low. I couldn't feel it manually with my hand, and of course the probe also doesn't reach that deep, so in such cases we scan the cotyledons and check for proper blood flow, and we can see here that the blood flow is present, which gives us a very high likelihood that everything is fine, the pregnancy is progressing, and the cow will carry it to term. I also wanted to show you a case where the corpus luteum blood flow was very weak, and this was later confirmed. I had a corpus luteum and a follicle that would normally make the animal ready for insemination. However, I decided to administer prostaglandin and waited 2 weeks before starting the protocol. Why? Because the blood flow in the corpus luteum was very low, and indeed, this was confirmed. There was no estrus. The corpus luteum was broken down by the prostaglandin, as expected, but there wasn't a rapid drop in progesterone. Most likely, the luteal tissue wasn't producing enough progesterone anymore. And we know that the best estrus results come when there's a rapid drop in progesterone. That's why when I see weak blood flow, I generally don't proceed with insemination. It's also important to note that weak Doppler signals may appear when the animal is moving a lot. The image gets blurred. So you really need to stabilize the ovary in your hand, because if the animal is moving too much, the image may be distorted. So a word of caution: to get reliable Doppler results, the animal doesn't have to stand completely still, but it helps if at least your hand is steady when holding the probe and the ovary. Otherwise, the blood flow signals may look somewhat blurred. Let me know in the comments what your experiences are with using Doppler.